I'm Steve Amber and I'm Shirley Gibb with expression in VOA Special English. Imagine standing at the edge of a tall bridge. Hundreds of meters below you, river waters rush by. You take a deep breath and jump off the bridge, head first into thin air. As a reaction to such excitement of fear, the hormone adrenaline flows through your body. There is nothing but a long rubber rope attached to your ankles, holding on to your very life. Some people call it crazy, others say it is exciting, whatever you might think. Bungee jumping has become a popular extreme sport all over the world. Blum! Bungee jumping is not a new activity made up on Pentecost Island in the South Pacific. Have been doing land jumping for hundreds of years. The men tie long fins from plants around their ankles. They spend days building tail towers out of fins and long. Then they jump off these structures. It takes a great deal of skill to jump correctly and safely. Land diving for them is an important cultural art. According to their beliefs, the first flight diver waits a moment. Woman C decides to run away from her abused husband. So she climbed up a tall tree and tied some fins around her feet. Her husband chased after her up the tree. He reached out to grab her, but woman jumping and the man followed. The fins saved her life, but her husband died. Land diving has become a way in which the Island men would show their bravery in front of the woman. People of the village sing loud songs to show their support for the brave divers. This tradition is also a way for the men to voice their trouble in public. For example, a man can discuss his marriage problems before he jumps. The village, including his wife, must stand and listen. This action custom called the instance of some students at Oxford University in England in the late 1970s, they formed a group called the Dunger Sport Club. They liked to invent risky and something crazy activities. They were some of the first people to test several of what are now called extreme sports. They are said to have invented modern bungee jump. In the spring of 1979, members of the group jumping off the Clifton Suspension Bridge in Bristol, England. They were attached to the bridge by a bungee cord along a elastic rope. Stretches, they were dressed in black and white clothing and held bottles of champagne wine. The press quickly reported on their wild activities. The group soon received even more attention when they organized a bungee jump off the Golden Gate Bridge in San Francisco, California. A man named E. G. H. Hackett of New Zealand later heard about this group. He decided to make the sport into a business. Mr. Hackett worked with his friend Henry Van Asse, who was an expert at skiing. They started developing bunga ropes and material. Scientists at Auckland University helped them. The two men knew what people would find bunga jumping exciting and fun, and they knew people would pay money for the experience. To show the world about bunga jumping, they held a major jump in 1987 of the famous Eiffel Tower in Paris, France. They later got permissions to open the first bunga jumping operation on the Coral Bridge in Queenstown, New Zealand. Many people paid $75 to jump off the bridge with a bunga cord attached to their ankles. Mr. Hackett worked hard to make sure the public knew how safe his material were. He developed a method to grant safety called the bunga code of practice. Bunga jumping might seem frightening, but it's a very safe activity if you will go to a well-established bunga jump company. People who work for bunga operation usually have a great deal of training and experience. They use very strong and careful mother rubber ropes. They cause a rope base of the jumper's body weight. This is so they can manage how much the rope stretches when the person falls. The rope attached through a harness device tied around the jump's ankles. Often, operator uses a body harness as well. This is so that you have to switch the protection in case on harness breaks. Good bunga operation makes sure all equipment is in excellent condition. They also do several checks to make sure all ropes, harness, and these are collection attached. It is important to remember that this sport is not safe for everyone. People who have high blood pressure or a heart condition should not try jumping. People with bike or knee injuries or who suffer from epilepsy should also avoid this sport. And remember, if you don't feel like experiencing it yourself, you can always watch other people jumping. Now you have jumped, bounce up and down several times on the rubber rope and hanging by your ankles in the middle of air, you might be wondering what you are supposed to do now. Do not worry, the operator have different coins for getting you back to land right side up again. Oftentimes, a bunga guide on a rope will attach to your rope and help you back off to the structure you jump from. On extreme, support company gives a warning on this website. It warns that bunga jump might lead to big smile and deep feelings of happiness and extreme. Since its beginnings in New Zealand, commercial bunga jumping has to country everywhere. One of the highest bunga jumping in the world from a truck is near Locarno, Switzerland, over the Berchtesgaden. The drop measured 220 meters. In fact, you can see the character James Bond jump off this very bridge in the 1995 movie Golden Age. Or there is the 216 meter jump for the blockers bridge in South Africa. This is highest single arch bridge in the world. Of course, not every place has a body of water with a bridge from which you can jump. Some amusement parks offer bungee jump from Carmichinery in the Andes Mountains of Peru. You can visit Action Valley outside the city of Cusco. Visitor can jumping from a metal box that hung from cable hick up in the air. Most of this company can sell you video recording or photograph of your jump. This is why you can talk to your family back home that you're were brave enough to bunga. Now, extreme sport companies are finding ways to make bunga jumping even more threatening. Some of bunga jumping at night or jumps where you fall off a structure backward. There are also bunga jumping from flying helicopter and hot air balloons. You can also try bunga jumping for two. Some companies can harness two people together so you and a friend can experience twitch the excitement. IZ Hackett's company even offers a sky jump of the tallest building in Macau. Just how far will you go to experience the fast rules of bunga fair? Hosea Muzingwa helps run a bungee operation on the Pretoria Falls bridge between Zimbabwe and Zambia in Africa. He has been jumping from this 111 meters drop for many years from the steel bridge. You can see the giant waters of Pretoria Falls, one of the largest waterfalls in the world. Mr. Muzigua explained that every human being wants to feel the rush of adrenaline. He said, when you bungee jump, your life all stays and but thinking behind. He said, you come back with a new but what does a person who is new to bungee jumping think about this sport? Tim Runai secretly traveled to Pretoria Falls. He only had 24 hours to spend in Zimbabwe, but he made sure he found time to jump off this famous bridge towards the powerful Zambezi River. Here is what he had to say about the experience. Tim Runei. Hi, I'm Tim Runei from Washington, D.C. Jumping off the bridge was one of the most spectacular footage moments of my life. The idea had really occurred to me until we got to the falls and we saw the view. I decided what better way to get to know this view than to jump into it. I think that the jump had more of a scary impact on my girlfriend, who had to watch the whole thing. To an observer, a bunga jump looks like a terrible violent process, but the actual experience of this is one of looting. You jump and you don't have any sensation of being too good or failing or anything. You're just are floating up and down. This is one of the most calm, wonderful things I have ever done. I recommend everybody do.